What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. My name is Joel Sam. If you're new to this channel, as always, I invite you to subscribe to this channel where every week I try to put out content that will help you become financially free. The goal of this channel is to put out content that will help people find opportunities online to make legitimate money so that they can break out of the cycle of poverty and meet all their goals, targets, and aspirations in life. If this sounds like something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and leaving this video a like. So in today's video, I want to address a very critical issue that has been coming up since I posted my PayPal videos. I get a lot of people messaging me asking why PayPal is blocking their account, why they are unable to transfer money to other PayPal users, and why Lesotho numbers are being demanded of them before transactions are finalized. So this video wants to address the issue in detail and propose solutions out of the troubles you may be facing. Before I go on, let me issue a disclaimer. I am not a PayPal representative. I have not been employed by them. I do not work for them. And I'm issuing this disclaimer because so many people messaging me with the notion that I work for PayPal or I'm some kind of representative and therefore I have all the solutions to their problems. The answer is that I do not work for PayPal. I'm no representative of theirs. They do not even know about me. What I do is I find opportunities online for making money and, you know, facilitating transactions and all of that. So I'm just an adventurous person. I'm just a curious person looking for solutions online. And as and when I discover them, I publish them on my channel. So please take note, I'm no representative of PayPal. I'm not a customer service agent. I do not work with them. I do not work for them. So with that out of the way, let's jump right into today's video. So it's been a couple of months since I released my first video about PayPal. That video did so well. Currently it's heading towards 100,000. And I get the feeling that it has helped so many people out of their PayPal issues. The problem is that a few weeks or months ago, PayPal updated their policy agreement, okay? And that made it a bit, not illegal, but problematic to use PayPal from a country that is not officially registered for PayPal use, a country such as Ghana, okay? So per this new policy agreement, it is mandatory for you to give some proof of the fact that you are a resident in Lesotho, you understand? It's still okay to be from Ghana, provide your Ghanaian details, but then you need proof that you actually reside in Lesotho because now you can only use it. They are very strict about it. You can only use their service from countries that they have allowed. And Ghana is not on that list. So once you are signing in from Lesotho, it means you need to provide a phone number from Lesotho or an address, a residential address from Lesotho to prove that you are actually resident there. Once they discover that it is not the case, then they block your account. So that is what is happening currently. That is the reason why so many of you are unable to send payments to other PayPal users without verifying a Lesotho phone number. It's the reason why so many of you are also getting your accounts blocked with no explanation. Sometimes they are gracious enough to send you an email explaining this new policy agreement, explaining the fact that they cannot allow you to continue using their service because you are in a country that they do not recognize for PayPal use. So please take note of this. Regardless of this new policy agreement, the method still works. Okay, you can still sign up for a PayPal account using Lesotho details and it will work. It may work very briefly and then they'll begin to ask you for documents to prove that you are residing in Lesotho. But for that brief period when you need to send money and then all of that, it still works. The disclaimer though is that you continue to use PayPal at your own risk. You continue to use it at the risk of being blocked, at the risk of having your balance or your money locked in their system, okay? So I don't think it's necessary to risk it if it is not extremely urgent that you transfer money to their platform. Especially for people who work on Fiverr and other freelance platforms, it can be so painful if you've worked so hard, accumulated a very huge amount of money, say $1,000 or $2,000, they are ready to withdraw your funds and then everything is blocked. You cannot withdraw it. It's going to be very, very painful. So be sure you know what you are doing once you sign up for the PayPal account. I'll keep looking for solutions out of the problem to ensure that we still have access to PayPal and we still find a way of sending our payments to our friends and our loved ones who are outside Ghana and then receive funds from them as well. If you're a freelancer on Fiverr, which I talk about a lot on this channel, aside PayPal, the other payment withdrawal option that is available is Payoneer. Okay, but with Payoneer, you need a bank account. And what happens is that once you sign up for an account with Payoneer and you have linked your bank account, anytime you withdraw money from your Fiverr balance, Fiverr would put it into your bank account straight away using Payoneer as the medium, okay? And so it's okay to use the Payoneer. I really don't see any issue with it. The only difficulty may be you do not have a bank account, but it's not so difficult getting one. So if you work on a platform like Fiverr, you may want to consider that payment option, that withdrawal option. It's very convenient, it's accepted in Ghana, it's very easy to use. So why stress through PayPal? Just move to Payoneer and then make something out of yourself. I'll put out a video later explaining how to set up Payoneer and all of that. There are some videos online already. Maybe if I find a few of them, I'll link them in the description so that you can watch them as well. But then if you're on Fiverr, please, very important, don't risk your hard-earned money with PayPal. Try to set up Payoneer and use that method to withdraw your funds instead. If you are on other platforms that you need to withdraw your money, there are still other payment services which accept Ghana, okay, and which you can use very easily. If you still need to send money to your friends and loved ones, there are still other services which accept Ghana actually and are very easy to use, okay? We have Skrill, we have Pompey, we have so many of them. As time goes on, I'll try to create videos on how to set them up, how to use them so that you benefit from them. You don't have to be trapped in PayPal. You don't have to be so worried about the fact that they are being very entrenched in their position to blacklist Ghana. I remember a few years ago, the government promised to put things in place to ensure that that ban is lifted from Ghana and we are able to use PayPal very freely. That promise was made about 2 years ago. I'll play it for you to have a look.
I'm also happy to announce that Ghana has concluded discussions with PayPal. And Ghana will therefore, if all goes well, become one of the PayPal compliant countries in two phases. According to the roadmap presented by PayPal, by the second half of 2019, which is next year, Ghanaian merchants should be able to receive payments for their goods sold online. By the first half of 2020, Ghanaian consumers would be able to make payments for goods and services purchased online by the PayPal accounts. It is now up to us, the Bank of Ghana, GIBS, banks, fintechs, telcos, and merchants, to make this happen within the time frame, and also to prepare ourselves for the opportunities it presents. I would ask GIBS to put together a working group of stakeholders to work to implement this roadmap. This presents exciting opportunities for Ghana, and we should take full advantage of it. We should see, amongst other developments, a major boost in e-commerce in Ghana. We are indeed building a new and modern economy.
Okay, so down the line, for reasons best known to the government, the promise has not been fulfilled, okay? I just want to believe that they are putting things in place to ensure that this becomes a reality, because it's going to help so many of us who are actually working online to make a living for ourselves, to make ends meet and to meet all our goals, dreams and aspirations in life. So it's something I actually look forward to so much. In the meantime, while we wait on government to fulfill its promise, you may want to check out these other platforms I've mentioned: Skrill, Netella, Payoneer, Poundpay, so many of them. As I've said, I'll put out videos soon illustrating how to use them so that you can conveniently and easily send your money from one place to another without any hassle, without any stress. It's my hope that someone at the helm of affairs in government would come across this video that I've made and will realize how this issue with PayPal is really affecting so many of us, okay, and then speed up the process to make sure that the blacklist is removed from Ghana and we can easily and conveniently use PayPal's platform. The difficulty is that so many platforms, whether it's for freelancing, whether it's for dropshipping, whether it's for forex trading, so many of them require PayPal as a withdrawal method, okay? And that is where the difficulty lies. So once government is able to deal with that situation for us, it opens us up to so many opportunities, okay? Endless opportunities online for us to make something out of ourselves, help the government in its quest to reduce unemployment and help the youth make a living for themselves. So it's my hope that someone at the helm of affairs sees this video. If you are watching me right now and you know someone who is up there, feel free to share the video. Let them know that this is something that is very present and dear to our hearts, and we'll be so grateful to them if they can speed up the process so that we can use PayPal freely in our dear homeland, Ghana. All right, guys, thank you so much. This is what I have for you today. I hope the video helps. I hope the video puts a lot of light on a lot of issues that you were confused about. Like I've said, if you decide to continue using PayPal, you do it at your own risk, okay? The method I put out some months ago still works. You can still withdraw your money and all of that, but you don't know at which point they will demand proof of residence from you. And once you are not able to provide all of that, they block your account. So you use it at your own risk. I'll look for ways around the problem to see how we can go about it and still use PayPal. I would also put out videos on other payment platforms that you can use and how to use them. Thank you so much again for being with me. I'll see you in my next video. Peace.